Nikita Khrushchev, it is a Russian dictator who became a dictator after Stalin. And it's the 29th of September, 1939. And I find exactly what he say in that particular time. In my book, there is that documents and so on. He just, in that moment, he said, so Germans were just behind in that side of river. And he just came here and he said, let's German made all the crimes. We will liberate Europe later. More crimes we create, it's better for us, yeah? Because all Europe will ask for a liberation. Yes, it is a Russian oil for Germany. When we just looking history, Battle of Britain, there is Spitfire and Messerschmitt. Wow, wow, wow. Spitfire and Messerschmitt. And I always say, please, there is a three actually persons here. Spitfire, Messerschmitt, and Russian oil. Without Russian oil, nothing will happen. Battle in Atlantic, you see, so where is the Tirpitz, Scharnhorst, Gneisenau, German submarines, I say, and Russian oil, yeah. Without Russian oil, so why comrade Stalin just supply Hitler? If he say no oil, no aluminium, no not food, you see, so the war will stop immediately. Anyway, comrade Stalin, yes, that is the situation. It's a British cartoon of 1941. Adolf Hitler prepared attack of Great Britain. He just planning. Look the situation. Yeah, I like that situation. Look that, yeah. And comrade Stalin behind say, please do it, yeah. Why not? And somebody can say, but Red Army was not ready for a war. Yes. And all of you, you just read hundreds of books. Red Army, don't ready for a war. I say, stop. Not ready for defense. It's a different thing. Not ready for a war and not ready for defense. Ready for a war. Readiness. Please, let's look last day of the war. May of 1945. And please give me answer who is ready, who is not. Adolf Hitler commits suicide. He is ready for a war. Come on. Of course, Russians have a very bad start, and I explain why very bad. Because if I prepare to attack you, so just I'm exposed myself. And in that time, you see, so Adolf Hitler just so boom, like that, you see, oh. And it's a why. I'm sorry, ladies, you see, so I'm very rude guy, but I'll try to explain my ideas. The point is, when you prepared for an offensive war, you have a different kind of equipment. For example, it is a T-40. Only one country in the whole world have an amphibious tank in that time. And it's the Soviet Union, T-40. Not Germany, not America have no amphibious tank in that time. But in an offensive war, you need them. You have to cross the rivers. In a defensive war, you just withdrawing your troops and blow up the bridges. You don't need amphibious tanks, yeah? So best amphibious tank, T-40. It is a T-37. That is a T-38. We just carry them, you see, so under aircraft, you see, across front line and drop like that. It is a quite technology, you see, so look that, like, whoop. Look at that. So when it's amphibious, come forward. In defensive, when Hitler attack, we have to protect our country. We don't need all that technology at all. We don't need amphibious tank. We abandoned them. Look at that. It is BT-7. It's a beautiful machine. What is good about that? It can drop trucks, you see, so, and in a motorway, it's 100 kilometers, 70 miles, yeah, in a motorways, whap. But Russia have no motorways now, yeah? Why you need motorway tanks if you have no motorway? But Germany have. So they in a truck, they fighting in our territory a little bit, you see, so when they come to motorways, you see, so they drop the trucks and come forward. Yes, if there is a blow up bridges, it is so powerful it can jump over bridges, you see, over river. Nobody have such a technology now. Look that, it's T-34. It's the best tank of Second World War, and actually it's the best tank of all time. German captures them, and the best German division used T-34. Yes. Look, it is a German tank. We have two best tanks, Panzer II and Panzer IV. It's Panzer III. The gun, what is it? You see, it is so strange. Look that. Look that. It is a 6-inch gun, yeah? 6-inch, 152. Nobody now, no one country, including Russia, have such guns on their tanks. But that tank you cannot use in defensive war because it's quite slow, you see, so very big shell, enormous shell. Why we have such tanks? If you have a fortification in front of you, you have to have a very big shell. Just destroy fortification. Actually, we use it in Mannerheim line in the Winter War, 1939-1940. It was very successful. When Germans attack, you don't need such a tank at all. So, please come in. It's the best German tank, PC-3. Please look the gun. Please look that. It's quite different, yeah? Look. What is the best German self-propelled gun of 1941? It's near Moscow. Pay attention how short the barrel. You see, it's a caliber 75 millimeter, but barrel is so short. Look that, yeah? Isn't it? Now, it is an abandoned Russian tank and it is a German anti-tank shell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's only in that small place, yeah? So we cannot penetrate it. So, and Russians say, we are not ready for a war. I say, look that. That is a KV, and actually it is from behind. Look, and it's a very big shell here. You see, so, and we cannot penetrate it. Nobody in the world have a tanks like that in 1941. It's a German tank, you see, so if there is something, it's destroyed immediately. So if there is something shell, more or less big one. Before, it's a Russian howitzer, you see, so each shell 100 kilograms. So it's very good to fight, yes, that one, that one. If you're fighting in a Königsberg, if you're fighting in Berlin, yes, you need such a thing. You see, so there is lots of buildings in front of you, you put like that. And, but in a defensive war, you cannot turn it left and right. It's too heavy, 17 ton. So it's the best in the world, you see, so for a street, yes, nothing better. But in 1941, what we have to do, to put some sand inside of barrel, or is one shell, press a button, you see, so, and that howitzer destroy itself. In defensive war, we don't need it. So some of Russian airfields, now they say it's a bad aircraft, and so on and so on. Some Russian airfields was 2 kilometers near German border, 2 kilometers. But airfield Высокое near Brest, 800 meters to border. So if you come up, you over German territory immediately. But if Germans attack, we use just sniper or just ordinary rifle, just killing Russian pilot, you see, so. So if you're for offense, if you prepared yourself for offense, it's a right position for your airfields. Your army come forward, you have to support them, they come forward, you have to support them. But if they attack you, you see, so what is happened with Russian aviation? Germany have 3,000 aircraft, Russian have 21,000 aircraft, you see, so. And now they say it was a bad one. But even it's a MiG-29, you see, 800 meters near the border. What you will do? You will lose them immediately. Motherland called you. It's a very famous slogan of before the war. You see, so, but I have to pay for attention, and it's, say, 15th of March 1941. When Hitler attacked, you see, everywhere Mother Russia called you, yes? But they published it 2 months before German attack, yeah? How we know? And Stalin never know, you see, so Stalin don't believe when Hitler attacked. He was very surprised, you see, so, but everything was prepared. And look that. Кратко русско-немецкий военный разговорник для бойца. So the short Russian-German phrasebook for soldiers. It is published. It's published 29 of May 1941. Wow. Wow. You see, so why if we don't waiting for a German attack? So, but immediately, it was a Moscow print. Immediately, it is the 5th of June 1941. It's a Leningrad. So we start to publish it in Odessa, in Kiev, in Minsk, in Riga. 6 million of them. So every soldiers you see have a here in the boots. You see, so you just open it and just, for example, захват железнодорожной станции разъезда. Как называется эта станция? In the German, we heiste diese Station, and in the German, by the German. Stop. Stop. If it is a great patriotic war, and we're fighting for our homeland, you and me, we come in into some village, you see, and say, we heiste. Come on, we say, this is Smolensk. We're in Russian territory. So, oh, for example, here. Прекрати передачу, иначе застрелю. So it is just, please stop sending your telegram, I will shoot you. So just, actually, I just find exactly same phrase book German use, you see, so, and I think, come on, come on, come on, come on. It's have to be difference. It's have to be difference between Russian and German. And I try to find difference. Exactly same thing, we say, what is the name of that, you see, so just, I think it's have to be. One night I don't sleep, second night, and suddenly I say, oh yes, I got it, I got it. Sometimes Germans say bitte, you see, so Russian never say that. You see, please, we say German. Вам нечего бояться, here it's just, вам нечего бояться, скоро придет Красная Армия. Sie brauchen keine Angst zu haben, bald kommt die Rote Armee. Please don't worry, Red Army will be soon here. Yeah? Isn't it? Somebody say, where is the document? I say, what is the document? Yeah? Isn't it?